But last night, I don't.
Wait. When last night, what?
Last night, when you guys refused to wake up and fighting that guy, there's a crazy man wielding a huge sword walking around.
I knew where everything was. I was just like.
And interrupt my beauty sleep. Now that everyone can wake up and look this regal.
Wait, did you change?
Agreed.
I'm an elf, yeah. I'm my elf of the blue, beautiful gold leaf.
Oh,
cloak.
Yeah, that.
The upper,
the
middle,
boy.
Lower class looking elf.
Yeah, the fuckboy.
Fuckboy?
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 Do you guys have, like, paper towels?
Yes.
Okay.
Paper
towels are under the sink.
Under the sink?
Under the sink.
And then wet one a little bit. Wet one.
32 degrees outside, I am. It's cold as fuck, my balls freeze off.
Under the sea.
We need to become a band.
So, as you get closer to the hill, the mud around does start to become more of the bluish gray kind of clay almost.
I want to make it pop.
Pumpkin will relay that. He'll be like, this is the stuff that they cake themselves with. Blah.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. They are tough like this.
Roll
blah,
perception.
Blah,
blah. I'm going to dry my hands here. And then here.
13?
This one's kind of wet. I didn't have any towels.
13?
So you do indeed notice that the color of your robes has changed from these nice elegant clothes to quite dirty and dingy clothes.
I notice, and then I look at the bard.
This is what I get for using other souls.
You know, there was a point in time we worked pretty well together. In fact, we took down a headquarters of a cult and burned them down and came out even the better.
What's going on?
When did I piss in your Cheerios? Is this some chauvinistic way to capture Irina's love? Is she into this kind of, it's just a prank, bro, bullshit? Or is this just your fetish?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Alright.
What's going on?
Is his spell more powerful than my disguise?
Well, you disguised yourself and changed everything. Then after that, he changed something else. So it's not like altering another spell. You changed everything you had, and then he changed it.
Yeah, his disguise
just after you
is
made that
changing,
about being
so he's
fancy.
He is
changing it.
I also don't
doing something
people.
We don't know what he's doing.
Alright. Excellent. I like brush the cloak up on my shoulders.
I like how Facebook loves me so much, or knows me so much, that it always recommends the ads for the little speed radars for your car.
So you can detect when a cop's catching you on
but
his gun.
They don't work.
No.
Depends.
They have multiple radars in their car that they use at the same time.
They have radars and then they have radar detectors too, and
yeah,
you
just want this.
Is there legal in certain states?
They're illegal,
like the state.
Utah.
I say, you know,
Utah.
Like,
they're illegal to own, not illegal to sell. Funny enough, which I find dumb as fuck.
But if you're selling them, then you do own some.
Not necessarily, because under certain like merchant laws or distributor laws, you can sell shit, you cannot buy shit.
That makes no sense. But
I only know that because Best Buy actually sells radar detectors.
But you can't buy
But you can't own a radar detector.
Can you rent one?
No.
I'm just borrowing it, officer. It's not mine.
It's not mine.
I didn't buy it. Exactly.
Yeah, that's an interesting loophole there.
I
don't
own
it.
This.
But yet it is in my car, which I do own.
Possession is 9/10 of the law.
It would
though.
Be a lot harder to prove that you do own it than it would be
to buy
prove.
It in cash.
Yeah.
Just
you
don't have a receipt. There's no way that I can trust you.
Yeah, you have to buy it in cash.
I don't know, man.
I think they would still do the thing where it's your car, everything in that car, or you're the driver, everything in that car is
maybe
yours.
In possession of it. We don't own it.
It's like, I'm in possession of this weed, but I don't own this weed.
I don't know. I still think they would get you.
Maybe.
We'll definitely get a ticket.
You could just be like, oh, my friend told me that this was a camera. It was a dash cam. Hopefully
you
have a stupid police officer. It's like that
wrong?
Does
it does kind of look like a camera, though.
Yeah. It does. So,
but they do have that little thing that goes beep, 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 beep when it gets near another radar.
Yeah, I was
wondering
why I was doing that every now and again. Sometimes I drive by the store and it goes off, so I don't know what's going on.
Oh, and you going,
it'll detect the
120 miles per hour isn't foretelling that you have it.
The automatic doors will set it off.
So dope. That's cool.
The sensor from the doors.
That's annoying.
You know how fast you're going? Oh, I was going 120. You know what that is? Oh no, officer, that's not mine.
If that was a record, sir, would I have been going 120 miles an hour next to you?
Yeah.
He's all, one second, let me
I thought it was a
dash cam detector that I
I was doing a stunt and I was recording it.
Anyways.
So as you guys
approach, that'll get you out the ticket. This recording is stuck. Alright, as you guys.
Mm-hmm. We're encroaching on up this hill.
What's our order?
Yeah, I do need to know your guys' walking order.
You
were kind of
the
main point with
where's my thing? Oh, thank you. God. You're so mean.
My kitty cat face is right there. I can't reach it.
I wish I had my hat to put on my horse.
Okay, well, this is me on Harris. This is Harris when I'm on him.
Okay.
This is Wolf.
Okay.
How wide is Road?
Like 10 feet, two of you can walk side by side.
Funk, can you want to be in front?
Darn.
She's behind you, not next to you.
I'm Catbug. Have you been watching season 4 on work?
Okay.
I don't have very.
Right.
I have.
So cool.
So you guys, you and Pumpkin are up front?
Wait, are we going this way or that way?
I'm going. Cool.
I assume
I'll
that's
just
what
be.
She's that's the way
okay.
I'm spacing.
Alright.
Okay.
Oh, you stay in the back. We can take away with
you.
You
end up approaching the hill.
Whoa.
Ooh.
And as you guys come here, you see that the path branches off every couple of feet. And there's mounds and mounds of rocks, like just piles of rocks.
Huh. Wonder what we... Let's move on out of place.
Are those graves?
There's
don't
a,
the bear.
There's a circled wall with a path that runs through it up on top. And that's about 10 feet to 15 feet in some spots. It's just piled rocks.
Looks like Stonehenge to me.
And then in the center of this grove of trees, you can kind of see one that's it's quite large, but it looks withered and dying.
We can see it from here?
Sure. They're tall trees.
Oh, I'm sure. Withered and dying tall trees.
Yes. One is withered and dying.
Bardic knowledge to know if I recognize.
Yeah,
I was gonna poke your leg and be like, so you want to show it, tell us what this is?
17.
That's a good
question.
So can you
this,
talk to a plant here?
It does look from the rock cairns. It looks that a lot of them are burial mounds. Like there may be piles within them or unburied underneath is where bodies are.
Okay.
However, the circle on top is more like a druid circle and doesn't quite match the burial mounds.
And I instantly
this
recognize that.
Mike,
well,
your type of place.
That.
Wait, hey.
So
the
not.
Fuck am I supposed to be? A druid?
Oh yeah, that is true.
Oh yeah, it is true.
You recognize that there's a druid
what
circle.
What circle is it?
Crazy.
There's not...
Crazy circle? Is it a spirograph?
There
it's not
are
a circle that you recognize at all.
See, that is definitely a druid circle. But
what kind?
That's a great question.
What is the use about having a druid around?
I don't know. Clearly.
I don't know.
Because clearly they're sane, religious practicing druids, and not just a bunch of insane, mud-coated fucks. Clearly, that's
the case.
You feel
like you're the smartest one?
Jesus Christ.
Also,
this is not smart.
This is the wall of fog. Anything beyond maybe the bottom of the hill is completely covered.
But nowhere else, not anywhere inside is not fog?
I mean, it's like continues. It's the wall of fog. But yeah, nowhere inside is like heavily covered or anything
it's
like
just
that.
Like,
that's the wall
okay.
We need to build. Sorry.
Oh man, I don't want to know any of your beliefs because I don't want to hate any of you.
It was a joke. Just throw that out there.
And if you voted for certain individuals,
and you guys can
see.
Can't
vote.
Yeah,
what?
You can't. You can't take it.
Oh, you can't.
He's not a U.S. citizen.
Not. Yeah.
He is a Spain citizen.
What? Whoa. I didn't know this. I just thought he was born in Texas.
He acts like it.
I thought that too for a super long time.
I was raised in Texas since I was 3, so.
So you were born in Spain?
Yeah.
Dude, that's pretty.
Go America! But I'm Spanish. That's basically where he's
at. Nice.
So,
a good place to live.
On top,
right.
You can see
it's a, cool place.
A single lone figure back behind the circle staring out into the fog.
Spanish stripper. No Spanish stripper from Texas.
Can I recognize him?
I want to make a perception check, see what he is. Or her. 23? Or that's an 8. 25.
It is a black cloaked figure staring away from you.
Hello!
And he seems to, like, notice you for a second and look back.
I'm gonna strut up on Harris.
I'm gonna
sneak follow.
I'm just kidding.
Roll a sneak. I'm not using it.
19, so 24 to stealth.
Yes, exactly. You're gonna see, I don't have these ones. You're gonna see.
I love that movie so much. Did you know that the coconuts wasn't like originally a gag? They didn't have the money for horses. Straight up, so they're like, how can we turn this into a joke? Coconuts. Like, there's so much of that movie that they were just like, okay. They actually came across that one guy who does, like, he's super famous for doing voices for, like, Planet Earth and stuff, and, like, animal shows, or he'll be, like, talking over castles, and, that scene where they come across him in the movie, and he's like, this 13th century castle has the quarrels that come out, blah, blah, blah. And then one of the knights comes up and, like, cuts him down. That was, like, they just came across him one day shooting, and he was doing filming a thing, and they were just like, hey, you want to, like, come on set and make a joke out of it? He's like, yeah. And it was, yeah.
I'm going to do a perception check to see if I notice anything weird about any of the Karens in the area.
He's jerking off your own soul.
That's fine, dude.
It's partially spiteful.
I can tell.
I'm gonna enjoy this orange drink.
You enjoy it, buddy. Because no one else will.
I'm at 50 miles.
Okay.
I'm thinking about it now. He's maybe water.
A lot of them are kind of mossy. And you imagine, like, if you went digging through it, you'd find bones. But other than that, nothing too particularly weird.
Oh!
It'd take you too long to search through all of
hello,
it.
Yeah. Friend! As I strode up to the black cloak figure.
Them.
So, as you start to get to the top of the hill,
yes.
You notice that through the fog you can see what he's looking at. And it looks like a distant town with a church thing.
Through the fog?
Mm-hmm.
Like
as
over
though,
the fog?
No.
Oh, just through it?
Like, staring at the fog, you think you can make out the shape of this, like, church and humble town.
Do I recognize it?
Yeah, what town are we by?
Yeah, what town is it?
What town are we by?
And I say, you don't know. You're not even sure that there is a town there because everything else, totally white.
Hmm.
But somehow you can see this town through the fog.
Okay.
I strode up. What town is that, sir? Man, who are you?
Then in a deep, gruff voice, who all is close enough? What are all of you guys doing?
I'm riding right up.
I was stealthing next to him.
Okay.
I rolled a 24.
Okay.
Or, total 24, sorry.
Okay, I got that. Who else is next to
me?
Okay, are you just walking up with him, or just trying to stealth, or?
She's on her horse.
Yeah, she's just walking.
Okay, and you?
Trying up behind him.
Okay.
We got nowhere else.
In a voice that you guys all recognize. From the one night where it was foggy and you were attacked by vampires.
Oh, I was
there. Oh, man. I don't like
this. Wait, was I there? Fucking vampires. When was this?
It was when you were taking.
You were stabbing and eviscerating that fuck?
That guy! Oh!
Okay. Your stone face comes back.
I'm ready.
You recognize the voice and suddenly he's like,
I'm hungry!
Sorry.
Thanks. Now I do.
Oh, it's crap.
That was a good. That was a good session.
Oh, that's cool.
This is the one part of the veil that I don't control entirely, at least. It is the one part of my entire domain that mocks me. That is my home.
Oh. 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 Oh.
Did you not hear that?
No, I'm just strong. I mean, sure, yes, your home. Where is that?
A little town long forgotten. I don't even remember the name now.
How long have you had your domain?
Approaching 200 years now, something of that.
Well, it's interesting to have a cultural conversation with you.
And say he's still turned away from you, staring.
It's interesting to have a cordial conversation with you. In midday, in fact.
I was gonna say, it's still foggy enough to prevent full sunlight.
Good thing the pond's here, I guess.
Indeed.
So, what's your goal?
I'm not sure anymore.
What was your goal?
My goal was to control my domain.
You have it,
how?
Clearly.
Hmm?
How?
In the way I have. My people are subjugated and safe. My...
Safe's a loose term.
Perhaps to you. In my eyes, they are safe.
What are you saving them from?
Nothing now. Nothing can get through the fog that I don't allow to.
See, the lie of tyranny is that one believes they are protecting when they are enslaving.
No people are enslaved. They all have their form of free will.
Can any of them leave your domain?
Some. A very rare few.
Interesting. Now, when we see you next, hopefully it'll be the last time.
It will be. The next time you see me, I will not nearly be so nice.
Neither will I.
Of course.
Can we just duck now?
Before it gets too ugly, where is my brother?
I know not of your brother.
You guys took him.
Who do you serve?
Talona, of course. She's the one who granted me this power to keep any out.
That name...
It's not the Morning Lord that most people serve, but...
Clearly not. You're not one for sunlight.
Not in the least.
Not a morning person either. Now, what do you offer?
I offer eternal life.
In what form?
In the form of this affliction that Talona gifted me.
Tell me more.
She came to me and taught me how to create a potion that affected my blood. And now my blood never grows old. And she's granted me magic powers beyond anyone's recognition.
I put fingers behind my back. Tell me how many there are. Just scare. I wouldn't waste your time with such trivial matter. Fireball!
Yeah.
No, God, no. Fucking idiot. Well, it was wonderful having a conversation. Hopefully one day I'll get to see your home the way you did 200 plus years ago.
Of course. But why don't you guys come by the castle sometime? I'd be happy to have you for dinner.
Have us for dinner, or have dinner with us?
I meant what I said.
Well, if that's an invitation, then I'll accept it gladly.
Anyway, Bucephalus, come, and you see this in, like, almost larger than Harris, like, but sturdier built. Black horse with flames jutting from the back of its head, walk out from the other side of the druid circle. And he mounts him, turns back to you guys, and says, this will be your only meeting with me before meeting with death. Felt I should introduce myself to my new playthings.
Why did you allow us in here? You allowed us into your domain. Did you not?
Did we see his face at all?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it's... He's not, like, obscuring himself. He's just wearing his hood.
You allowed us in here, did you not? Why?
I have grown bored.
So you allow playthings?
I allow playthings. I like to stir up a bit every now and then.
I could get that.
And he starts to walk off on his horse. And he shouts back, and druids, begin the siege on the ravens. And you hear a like crackling from behind you as six druids all get up from the ground in the druid circle and start chanting.
Well, this is our time, and I'm going to stride Harris back and start heading back to the circle.
Fuck the ravens.
Now, is there a clear way up to the top part of the up here?
Yeah, I mean, this is kind of like the plateauish kind of part of the hill.
I'm talking about the rocks, like the rock wall. You said there was...
Oh, there's two paths.
Excellent. Is there a clear way up on top of the rock wall? Because didn't you say there was like a path up there?
No.
Oh.
It's like 10 to 15 feet high, just rock wall.
I see. Never mind then. Come on, party, let's go!
You can see there's something like 20 foot tall mud and thatch statue standing in the middle, and six druids all around have just sprung up, like crawled up from the dirt and started chanting.
Party started!
And Bucephalus is riding stride out into the road, disappearing into the trees.
What a day.
That was interesting. Come on, let's go fight druids!
Yes.
We're gonna go fight druids.
Oh, I'm gonna strode up, and in druidic, I'm going to say, your master is a whore, and your mother were cunts. And then we're gonna start the fight.
Yeah, and all of them are ignoring you thus far.
That's fine. Sound cool to me.
Alright, how far apart are they all?
So let's draw it out.
I was gonna say, like, I'm having trouble visualizing this, so I was hoping we could do that.
Where is my bit?
Right there.
Right where you left it.
That is. Oh, fuck. One square is 50 feet. Fuck me, this thing's huge.
Just draw the circle then. Can you just manage the circle?
Even the circle is 200 feet.
Then.
And let's say each of these are 10?
50.
Yeah. Well, we can say each one of these are 10.
So you only have to
even
go 20?
Even then, I need 20.
Yeah.
4, 5, 6, 7,
you have enough.
9, 10. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, I'll go 2 down. That's a lot. It's not perfect. But
As long as it works.
Also,
yeah.
Yeah, that's good.
So we can like move what? How many?
Three squares. That's the statue that they're all chanting at.
Where are they at?
I thought it was in the middle.
No,
it's on me.
Okay. It's in. How many are there?
600.
So all of these are graves.
Huh?
How many? How many do you think there are?
No, I thought the Cairns and graves were on the outside. They're like on that outer, the very most outer ring.
I know. But if all those pop up with druids, we're screwed.
Well, this is going to get interesting quick, unfortunately.
Yes, it is.
Well, if I'm fighting like a druid, I will kill like a druid.
You said there are about 10 to 15 feet.
I have
that
flashback of
you
in the cellar.
The wall is about 10 to 15 feet tall.
Bastard.
Just two druids just punching at each other.
Oh, yeah. Of course, it's me, boy.
Eris is fighting, so.
Go ahead and make a perception. Everyone entering a circle.
Who's all in and where are we starting?
I'm going in. I'm having Aria stay outside of the circle.
With the horses. Will be. Where's Harris?
He used that as Harris.
Yeah,
before.
Oh, he's right. Harris is here. Irina.
16.
Eight.
Why did Strahd take Irina?
I didn't go in the circle. Did I need the roll for that?
He wanted to introduce himself first.
Alright.
Did I need the roll? I was staying outside the
wall. I
don't
think this horse stays up.
This is a perception.
Okay, I got 8.
One sec, rolling this roll.
Oh, this is perception. Oh, thank goodness. It's not my initiative.
Yeah. 13?
Or
did you get
12?
16.
Okay. You? I was going to enter the circle.
Well, even still.
Okay.
Perception.
13 for me.
My.
16.
I wouldn't set it on your paper.
I'll take it.
I do. I don't mean to get snappy, but I have had a lot of fun playing D&D with you guys.
Aww.
Like, genuinely. Like,
such a nerd.
Like, even the other D&D was like, didn't happen when it was supposed to happen ever. Like, you'd go weeks and weeks without playing. People there wouldn't fucking participate. Like, it was awful. But, like, you guys actually want to play, or you give the great illusion that you do, which is more than appreciated.
Just here for the free food,
just
here for the
free food.
Just here for the free food.
No, I don't, because it wasn't fun. It stopped being fun, like, I don't know. But thank you. Like, had a good time with you guys.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Who rolled what?
So I'm going to attack him.
Now I'm going to kill a character now.
Who rolled over 15?
Nope.
So all of
D-Wolf. D-Wolf and Harris.
Can D-Wolf just be licking himself?
He's just licking his balls.
D-Wolf no longer notices the druids.
So as you guys enter, once they all begin chanting, you hear the lightning crack as it strikes the wall 6 times. Doom, 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 doom.
That was cool.
Where is my 6?
Shit.
Where's my 11?
I think take out the one that's actually chanting first.
Fuck, if we're fucking. All of them are chanting.
We don't know if these ones will be.
Not the ones that just
and
spawned.
Where it struck, you two notice that it left behind 10 people, each wielding a dual, like, huge sword in their hands.
Oh, that was crazy.
Lightsaber?
Lightsaber.
Lightsaber!
So where the lightning struck...
I gotta put my hair up.
10 people.
There were 6 lightning bolts.
Now there's 12.
Okay, screw the guys chanting. Let's get the things that are not busy chanting.
I'm gonna start fucking up.
I didn't make 12 things, I only made 10 things.
I know. You don't happen to have 2 other kitchen magnets, do you?
Yes.
Tasha's.
Yes, we do. Give me a second.
Tasha's not fighting.
You just need 2?
Yeah, she's gonna say that.
I'm not fighting.
Everyone else die. She's been through too much shit.
Okay.
Probably. But I mean.
Yes, 2.
Take out the ravens. I have some beef with the ravens still. Like, I'm okay with these
so
birds killing.
Here's the
ravens.
Prince of Darkness. And here's that other chick from StarCraft.
Is your old.
Who got turned into
Kerrigan.
Yeah, Kerrigan. Who's so much cooler as a sniper.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I thought you said like 10 people arose. No, 6 druids arose all around the circle. And then the 6 more spawned.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
I need a drink. I'm thirsty as fuck. More than one way.
Hey. Alright, I'm gonna roll initiative.
Okay.
Alright, dice. Let's do it, do it.
Please give me the same number. Damn it.
10.
7.
3.
Oh, can I use my Bardic Inspiration?
Oh, yes.
Yes, please, sir. Please.
How long is Bardic Inspiration supposed to last?
10d10. So.
Until the DM tells him about
it. It lasts until the beginning of our next session.
Alright. Can I
10.
Pretend?
Awesome.
I'll
so
erase the one
17?
I had.
20 total.
20.
I need to roll. Yay, he got a
20. I need
to roll.
Someone got it.
This is for D-Wolf. And he has plus 2 or 3? 3? Dexterity?
2.
2.
Strength is 3.
So he's 15. Ragnall, not surprising, is 5. And Harris is 20-something. Let me pull up.
Maybe you shouldn't use that dice for yourself.
Nope.
It's red and green.
It's,
he has to.
Yeah, it's my curse. And dude, Will Wheaton has a curse. A literal curse.
Will who?
Will Wheaton. So he... Did you guys ever watch Acquisitions Incorporated?
I know of it.
Yes.
I haven't watched it.
So Will Wheaton used to play D&D. He still plays D&D all the time.
Will Wheaton?
Will Wheaton, yeah.
Will Wheaton?
He's also...
Like
he was
cool.
In the big... He was in the Big Bang Theory. He used to do shit. It doesn't matter. Point, well, point being... Yeah, he was. He rolls 1s and 2s and 3s with d20s. That's it. He doesn't roll any high. If he does, it's somebody else's die, and then the next roll will immediately be a 1. That is just it. And it is factual. He'll be doing anything with anyone. He was on Critical Role recently, and he does it. And it's just... It's fucking hilarious. Because because Matthew Mercer, this DM, this professional DM, turns to him and goes, "This is an impossibility. You are the outlier in this world, and your bad luck is the reason why we haven't died yet." Like, oh my god, it was like... There was a point in time where the DM goes, "Roll again." And he's like, "Rolls again." And he goes, "It's another 1." And he's like, "Roll again." And it's another 1. And he's like, "Your character just dies. Like, you're down." Like...
Sorry.
Yeah.
All right.
Digress.
Anyone 25 to 20.
Harris.
Harris.
I have a 20. I roll a total 20.
What's Harris's?
Well, one sec. I'm pulling it up right now, but I know it's higher than a 20.
And you rolled 20 exact.
No. Did I say that? I meant a total of 20.
Yeah.
I rolled a 7,
and
then I used Bardic Inspiration. Yeah. So I had a lot of help.
Yeah, he's at exactly at 20.
20 to 15?
D-Wolf's 15. Yeah, 15.
Okay. And then 15 to 10?
Wow. Wow, fuck us all.
What What'd you get? I got 7.
We got 5.
It was 3.
Oh.
I got 5.
I'm not in a circle.
The animal's
still,
gonna go first.
You know, we should like reroll.
I'm so sorry.
Wait. D-Wolf is that. Wait, where's Harris? Oh, Harris is the HK. Okay. I was like, oh, fuck me. Fucked.
Right. Oh, damn.
Oh, we're so screwed.
Two. Dire Wolf was what?
15.
15. 2. And then 15 to 10?
Nope.
No?
No.
As he places all the other ones. Right there.
I say,
he poured really poorly.
That's okay, we used our bad rolls on an initiative.
Yeah.
And then all our good rolls are gonna be for attacks.
That's what's
happening. Jinxed.
No, what?
And each square is 10, correct?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so you got time before
I
we
say,
get
it's,
swarmed.
It's spread out. You're not about to be, like, mobbed.
Can we even reach the ones that are, like, 15 feet in the air?
No.
Not yet.
Oh, yeah.
Most of you don't even recognize that you're there yet. You're still looking at the druids on the floor.
Oh, everyone else needs to sit where they're at. This is a pumpkin. Irina's outside. Nemo. Where are you? Are you black?
Nemo said
set where you want to be.
I'm outside the circle.
I just set where I want.
Are you with
outside
Irina?
The circle.
Oh, I already said that before.
Irina's outside the circle.
Yeah.
Pumpkin, where are you?
I'm inside.
I said I was outside.
Move your piece inside where you want to be inside.
Alright, and what were the
right
others?
Right under
the
butt.
No. No more. Wow, we're all fuck-ups.
I got a 7.
Gee, thanks. Not
you
like I spent the last 15 years of my life thinking that.
Jesus, dude. That got way too real for D&D.
That's true. Yeah, at least in my parents' eyes.
Funny.
He's just no.